You know, I've been accused of a lot of things. I have never, until today, been accused of attempted murder. Oh, it's deep and dangerous. Let's get into it. I get all that myself, and I feel like that is a very important thing when a woman is independent.
My mouth's a moist and the liquid is just going everywhere.
That's trigger points. Everybody has trigger points. Let's just be honest. Those are my trigger points.
Yoplait yogurt is like, I hit every single option possible. Baby, I did like baking. I think if you. Even though that's just a label, we're trans women, but we're still human at the end of the day. We want what everybody else wants, and that's just to be loved and accepted. That's all we damn want. Love and acceptance.
This is what we're going to do because I feel that I'm getting out of my character. So, this is what we're going to do.
It's time to be alive, isn't it? We came a long way. Hey guys, this is Maya Ray. Thank you for tuning in my newest YouTube video. We're going to do a little story time. You know how we do here at the Gavinsburg channel. So go ahead on and like, share, subscribe, comment, tell a friend, gonna tell another friend. Let's do all those good things before we get started. This story time is a little, I kind of wish I was making this story time up. I wish I was making all of them up, honestly, because I've had some things happen to me, baby. I wish a lot of these stories I was making up. But no, it's really my life. So today, that's almost breaking in, honey. So today, I was with my cousins and we were running a few errands. And when we got back from running our errands, everyone was unloading their items out of the car. So I proceed, it's too hot for me and I don't have any items in the car. So there's no need for me to be getting anything out the car anyway. So I proceed to go inside. It's cool inside, it's hot outside, okay? And it's just common sense. I don't need to sweat. And you know sugar the first thing to melt. Hello. So I head on to the house, inside. And my littler cousin, who just so happens to be my cousin who rode with us with errands, her child, who is 5, sweet little girl. She comes in there, she hits me with a pillow. Not hard, not disrespectful, just being a child. So after she hits me with the pillow, I grab all of the pillows off the sofa, every last pillow off the sofa, and I dump them on top of her. She proceeds to laugh. Mind you, while all of this is happening, my other cousin, who's a male, he's in there, he's just looking, you know, laughing, thinking it's funny, because it is funny. I mean, it's just me playing with my younger cousin who just so happens to be 5, and she's being a child, and I'm playing with her. So after I dumped all the pillows on her, I grab my keys and I run outside so she won't get her lick back. I run outside, and of course she chases me outside, running me all around the yard. And her mother, who is my cousin, she goes, "What you did to my baby? Why is she trying to catch you?" I said, "She's trying to get her lick back." So even the mom reached out and tried to catch me so her daughter can get her lick back. She didn't catch me. We're still playing. Everything's good. The sun is still shining. Everybody's happy. So then the mom is ready to go because the daughter never caught me. So the mom's ready to go. I guess she got to go do some things at home. Whatever she made it. You know, it's her life. And my younger cousin, who's 5, the 5-year-old, she never got her lick back. And she basically ignored her mom, still trying to get her lick back. And her mom was like, "I'm ready, let's go." So then the little girl, her whole mood changed. She starts getting pouty. So she goes into the car and she proceeds to cry. Now this is when everything takes a turn for the worse. Once the little girl starts to cry, my cousin, who's the little girl's mother, attitude change like that. Start cursing me out. What the F you did to my baby. Blah, blah, blah. And mind you, she's talking to me as if she forgot who I was. I'm Maya Ray, baby. Talk to me with respect. That may be how you talk to those other people, but you talk to me with respect. So I look at her and I say, I'm sorry. Because I'm confused what's going on. I'm sorry. She said, what you did to my baby? I said, we were having a pillow fight. She hit me with a pillow and I threw some pillows at her. And we were running around the yard. You're literally standing in the same yard we're running around. I mean, you told her to go and now she's crying. How is this my fault again? You hit her. Why would you wait? This is the mother talking. Why would you wait till I'm not around to make my daughter cry? And she was obviously scared. This is literally, swear to God, this is what this lady is saying to me. She was scared. And you could have smothered her. You could have smothered her. Just something about her telling me that I could have smothered her daughter. The same daughter who does gymnastics, jumps off tops of ladders and backflips in the yard and do all the cartwheels and all this kind of stuff. But me just dumping some pillows on top of her and running, not putting my weight on anything, just dumped the pillows on top of her and ran. But you're accusing me, saying that I could have smothered your daughter. So now you're saying that you feel unsafe with your daughter being around me and you're not around. So I asked her, I said, what do you possibly think I was going to do to your child? What do you think I've done to your daughter? I don't know. I wasn't in there, but now she's crying. Now she's fucking crying. You big and grown, and this is a five-year-old. I mean, going off. Mind you, that same five-year-old she's speaking about is the same five-year-old who I picked up when she fell down at a graduation not too long ago and skinned her elbow, her side, and wherever else she skinned herself. I picked her up and took her to the car, giving her care and love. But now, all of a sudden, I'm an endangerment to this child's existence. You get what I'm saying? This is something that just came out of nowhere for me. I'm a little lost. And my cousin, who's doing the talking, she just, I would like to let them release, because I want you to tell me exactly how you feel. Because when people are angry, that's when they reveal how they truly feel about you. Telling me, well, you don't understand. She's crying now, and she wasn't crying just a minute ago. You need to have some kids. And I told her, I don't want any kids. If your attitude is the result of you having kids, I don't want them, because that's a nasty attitude and that's a nasty spirit to have. She's just going off. Mind you, now I'm putting two and two together that this lady is actually angry at something else, and it can't possibly be me, but I'm just the closest target to her so she can attack. I mean, the stuff this lady was saying, y'all, blew me completely away, because me, this lady, mind you, we're cousins. She's known me my whole life. I've known her daughter, who was also my cousin, her whole life. Never once did anything to hurt anybody's child, especially hers. And she knows that, because she made the statement multiple times, multiple different dates to multiple different people. Yeah, Maya and the child's name, they're friends. Yeah, they friends. So we're so friends and all that good stuff. All of a sudden now, you don't trust me around your child? Oh, it struck a nerve. So I told her, honey, don't you ever worry about, as long as we live, me ever playing with her again. Because that's some serious stuff to say. That's fine. It's that nasty, ugly spirit she got. That's the reason she's in the situation she's in now. That's all I'm going to say about that. Because you can't possibly make me understand how on earth you making it seem like I've really done something wrong to your child, and I was just playing with your child in front of you. I always play with her. Then she made a statement, you don't even like kids. Ma'am, playing with kids may not be in my top five most exciting activities, but I definitely don't hate children. And you need to stop that. Just because I'm not walking around and have tons of kids like what you are accustomed to does not mean that I hate children. I don't hate children at all. But I don't have to explain that to you, because if I hated children, I wouldn't be somewhere playing with your child. Listen at yourself, think. You got to use your brain before you speak to me, because I only indulge in intelligent conversations. I don't like them foolishness. Lead it to the streets, to the ghetto. I don't like kids, but I'm always playing with your child. Willingly, I always play with your child. Willingly, I picked up your child when she hurt herself and walked her, carried her all the way to the car. But I don't like kids. Really. But I'm not shocked at all, because that side of my family, they, you know, the whole group, they are the type of people who, if you are a part of their immediate family, immediate as in sisters or children, you can't do no wrong anyway. You can shoot somebody in the neck, you ain't done nothing wrong. So someone who has that type of thinking, you really can't even have a reasonable conversation. With every other word out your mouth is a curse word. That's because you can't think of nothing else to express how you feel. You need to step your vocabulary up and actually sit down and read a book, instead of trying to draw me and paint me as some type of murderer, child murderer. So I could have slithered your child. I mean, stuff like that, I'm laughing, but stuff like that is very serious to say. Like, you could have smothered her. What? And you're really getting heated about this. And I made the executive decision to remove her off of all my social platforms. Let me tell you something. I am in a point in my life where things are looking really good for me. I'm really moving towards goals. I'm doing so good in life. Like, my life has never been better because I see where I'm going. I have no time for foolishness, and it can be from anybody. So please be offended when I tell you this. If you are not bringing me peace, love, and happiness, you have no place in my life. And I mean that until the good Lord calls me home. If you mean nothing positive for me, you cannot possibly have a ticket to my life. You're not welcome. You're not welcome. But I'm more sad for you. I got my allergies. Whew. Oh, I didn't want to see this on camera, excuse me. I'm more sad for you because your children has to grow up, and you are the first teacher that they come in contact with. And from that nasty attitude, you know, different than the girl I read last night. That's why these people, that's why the future of America may just be in a drain. It's because these parents are raising their children, and the parents themselves aren't even great teachers, because they don't know how to resolve issues without getting nasty and low down with people. Before I get too deep, because I don't want to read these people, because I have too much respect. I mean, I grew up with these people. These are my family. I love these people. But when you reveal to me that's the type of person you are, because this is not the first instant this happened. Like, this is the first time she accused me of murder. But this isn't the first time me and her exchange words. I tend to just, you know, brush it off. But, you know, enough is enough. And her sister, who was also my cousin, but I get it. That's her sister. I get that that's your sister, but what I don't get is why uphold your sister when she is wrong. Her sister sat there and allowed all this to happen. Like, she was just standing there looking, didn't say a word. But soon as her sister left, I stayed back because I wanted to ask her sister a question. Not the one that was doing all the talking, she left. The one that wasn't doing no talking, I stayed at her house for a few more minutes because I wanted to ask her. I said, did I do anything wrong? This is what hurt me. She said, I know you didn't do nothing wrong, Maya. I know you. That's what hurt worst of all that. You're supposed to know me. And you would think that I would actually be so evil to hurt a child? You would really think that I would hurt a child? Is that what you think of me? You never known me if you think I would hurt a child. You know me. And you still fix your mouth to insinuate that I would hurt a damn child. And not just any child, but my family. Okay. That's cute. I can't deal with stuff like that. And I hate to say this because it's going to be shady, but it's the truth. I 1,000% know for a fact, even though her sister said, I know you, Maya. I know you didn't mean nothing by it. I know you wouldn't do anything. Like, I know for a fact she's still going to have her sister's back, because that's the type of family that is. They like this. And there's nothing wrong with having your sister back. But at some point, when are you going to open your mouth and say, you know what, sister, that was wrong. That's our cousin. We know she ain't going to do that. We know Maya ain't going to hurt that girl. We know that. Come on, baby. We know that, but I'm expecting a little too much. And it hurts. It really hurts because these are your family. These are supposed to be your family, but at the end of the day, I got to keep moving forward. And if you ain't got nothing nice for me to tell me, and it's not, you're not bringing me any kind of peace, I just got to leave you in the rearview mirror. I do apologize. I'm sorry for saying this, but we have to say goodbye. We have to. And I can assure you, my life is still going to be good because I have love in my heart, baby. I ain't got all that hate. I ain't got no hate for y'all. And I hate getting like this, but I got to get with you sometime and let y'all know. I ain't got no hate for nobody. I read you and I keep on going. I don't have hate for people. Hate make you got wrinkles and all that kind of stuff. I ain't got hate. My life too good to have hate, baby. I'm too blessed to be stressed. Let me finish getting ready for work. I had to put my face on, do a little quick face, a little natural. The beat. I'm about to go. So let me do a little story time while I'm getting ready, because this is some fucked up shit. Damn, I've never been accused of being a murderer. I don't know to be honored or offended. Child, I can write a book about the shit that go on in my life. Y'all have no idea. And I continue to smile. I gotta go. I'm gone, y'all. Hey, one thing I can say, I've been learning this year alone has taught me, no matter if you were on the right side or wrong side, when it comes to family, they will always choose them before they choose the right side. Because I know I wasn't wrong in multiple situations, but I'm going to leave it alone. I know I wasn't wrong. If I'm wrong, anybody who knows me, if I'm wrong, I will pridefully say, I apologize. But hell no, I ain't wrong, so I'm not apologizing for nothing wrong. The only thing I apologize for is allowing you to think that you can talk to me like that. But anyway, you know I got it together. You know I don't just stand and let nobody talk to me crazy. But let me go ahead on, because it's said and done. What's done is done. And that's that. I just feel sorry for the children, because that's their mother. I'm gone. Bye-bye.